Good morning, class 2 children. Now I am going to start English language chapter 6, Harold our Hornbill. Already we have completed chapter 4 and 5. Now see the pictures of the birds, hornbill, crow, sparrow. Let us read a story about a boy's pet hornbill called Harold. The hornbill fell into the boy's grandfather's home one morning. Since then, he has been a part of the family. Harold was not beautiful by Hollywood standards. Now, children, one thing from the chapter we had done MCQ, like Hollywood, this is the answer, and we will give you 4 options. This will be the sentence, and instead of Hollywood or instead of Harold, 4 options should be there. He had a small body and a large head, but he was good-natured and friendly, and he remained on good terms with most members of household during his lifetime of 12 years. Here it will be 12, the correct answer, then 13, 14, 15 in this way. Household best friend were those who fed him, and he was willing even to share his food with us, sometimes trying to feed me with his great beak. While I turned down his offers of beetles and similar delicacies, I did occasionally share a banana with him. Eating was a serious business for Harold, and if there was any delay at meal times, he would summon me with raucous barks and vigorous bangs of his bill on his woodwork of kitchen window. Having no family, profession or religion, Harold gave much time and thought to his personal appearance. He carried a rogue pot on his person and used it very skillfully as an item of his morning toilet. This rogue pot was a small gland situated above the roots of his tail feathers, and it produces a rich yellow fluid. Harold would dip into his rogue pot from time to time and then rub the color over his feathers and the beak of his neck. It would come off on my hands where I touched him. Harold would toy with anything bright or glittering, often swallowing it afterwards. He loved bananas and dates and balls of boiled rice. I would throw him the rice balls and he would catch them in his beak, toss them in the air and let them drop into his open mouth. He perfected this trick of catching things, and in time I taught him to catch a tennis ball thrown with some force from a distance of 15 yards. He would have made a great baseball catcher or an excellent slip fielder. On one occasion he seized a rupee coin from me, a week's pocket money in those days, and swallowed it nearly. Children, read this half and thank you.